Hey guys, welcome back to our new video. I am Zokir Mayala, second year aerospace student.
Hi, I am Anmol Jain, second year avionics student.
So we are from Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology, Asian first institute dedicated to study and research to outer space.
So in this video, we will be discussing about branch-wise, category-wise, and gender-wise safe rank for IST. Also, we will be giving some suggestions regarding who should apply for IST and all.
So if you have not watched our previous video regarding IST admission, so link in the description or I button.
So let's begin with the video.
So what will be the cutoff for male candidates for IST?
So in this video, me and Jyotirmay have collected the closing ranks for each branch category-wise for the last 4 years. So you will get the closing ranks here. So for the further discussion about the male candidates, I will divide it into two parts. So first part, we'll discuss about general EWS, OBC, NCL male candidates. And second part, we'll discuss about SC and ST male candidates. So for the first type of students, we have listed the closing ranks here and we got the closing ranks for each year and each category. So if your rank is under this closing rank, then you should definitely apply for IST if you have not, and you will most probably get the seat here. Also, you should consider the last 2 year data only, because the data for 2017 and 18 is varying from them. So that was all about male candidates who belong to general EWS or OBC NCL category. So now I will discuss about SC and ST male students. So we have only one suggestion for them. It is about that if you are eligible to apply for IST, then you should apply definitely. Because as you can see from the eligibility video, that SC and ST students need only minimum 8% marks in advance to apply for IST. And the closing percentage is about 10 or 11. So as the difference is very low, so you have a very high chance to get into IST even if your JE advanced marks are low or rank is low. So for SC and ST male students, you should apply for IST if you are eligible for it. So that was all about the male candidates. So Jyotirmay, tell about those male candidates who did not get rank under this closing rank. What should they do now?
So Anmol, what I can suggest for general EWS and OBC NCL, that those student male candidate have rank difference of 4,000 to 5,000 from this basic cutoff rank, they must apply from IST registration, because they will get some good experience and opportunities from the council, and they have not great loss because it cost only 600 rupees only for them. And IST also provided some spot on counseling also. In that spot on, we can see that many students have a rank difference more than 2,000 to 3,000 get seat into IIST. So they must sit on this registration and counseling also. And so for SC and ST candidates, what I can suggest is if you are above the eligible criteria of IIST, then you must apply for IIST registration. So if you have not watched the previous video that we have made about the eligibility criteria for SC and ST student, so you must watch, and the eligibility candidates must apply for IST registration.
Right, Jyotirmay, you have explained it very well.
So Anmol, what do you think about the female candidates cutoff for IST? Because we can see that there is a new reservation for female candidates in IST. So we can see that we have no previous data for this reservation or something like that. So, and what do you think about the cutoff for female candidates?
Yeah, so about female candidates, IST have offered first time female reservation. So in the admission process, 13 seats are reserved for them. Also, they can compete in the gender neutral category. So they have a very good chance for getting admission this time. So if your rank is under this closing rank, you will definitely get the seat. But even if your rank is more than this closing rank by 10,000 or 15,000, then also you can get a seat, because in the female reserved seats, only female can apply. So there is no loss for applying into IST. So you should apply for it. The suggestion for SC and ST female candidates is same, just like the male candidates, that if they are eligible for applying, then they should apply. So that was all about the female candidates. So Jyotirmay, what is the one last suggestion that you want to give to all the students who are aspiring for ISC?
So one suggestion from my side is, if your rank is not under this cutoff rank, then don't be demotivated, be strong and wait for your turn, because IST conducted 18 rounds of counseling. So maybe you will get some more opportunity to get admission in IST. So we have made various kind of video related to IST. If you have not watched, then go to the playlist. And
do subscribe IST Insiders for more videos related to IST. Also, we have one good news that we have completed 1 lakh views on our channel. So thank you for that.
And thank you for your love and support, and do subscribe.